In the realm of small things, where probability and chance reign supreme, microscopic particles have terrific superpowers. Passing through solid walls, being in different places at the same time, or spinning clockwise and counterclockwise simultaneously, becoming so strongly correlated to lose their individual identity. But what is quantum really about? Over 100 years ago, some of the world's greatest scientists, in their study of the microscopic building blocks of matter, started to uncover a new world that defies common sense and logic. Developed to describe atomic scale phenomena, quantum science is the most fundamental of all physical theories, and it has never been disproved so far. It describes physical processes, from the cosmology of the early universe to how transistors and lasers work. But understanding it is a journey into the rabbit hole, through the weird and bizarre. If everything is made of quantum stuff, why can't we see these bizarre properties in our everyday life? Why can't we be in two or more places at the same time and have quantum superpowers? In principle, there's no reason why it couldn't happen, and it's actually connected to the holy grail of quantum physics, the so-called quantum to classical crossover. Quantum science describes small particles, but technological progress has allowed us to make bigger and bigger objects exhibit a distinctive quantum behaviour. So where is the border between the fuzzy microscopic world and the good old classical reality we experience daily? The mathematical implications of quantum science are uniquely hard to interpret and visualize, since they defy what our common sense and imagination can possibly grasp. But quantum science does work. There are tons of experiments that confirm it, and a whole new range of technologies, including quantum computers, are reaching the market. Indeed, quantum science is much more than just a theory. It's a new way of looking at the world. It forces us to drop out of our comfort zone, going beyond our mind frames and opening up to new concepts. Classical physics is to quantum physics as logic is to creativity. Activating our creative mind is the only chance to succeed. It represents the only superpower that we can use to travel through the mystery of the quantum world. In the words of the Nobel laureate Richard Feynman, there's still a school of thought that cannot believe that atomic behaviour is so different than large-scale behaviour. I think it's a deep prejudice. It's a prejudice to being so used to large-scale behaviour, and they're always seeking to fight the waiting for the day that underneath the quantum mechanics there's some mundane, ordinary balls hitting or particles moving in something. I think they're gonna be defeated. I think nature's imagination is so much greater than man's, she's never gonna let us relax.